There is a wild, wild west out there that is typically not managed, and it's very difficult to control. And we are talking about UEFI. What happens before Windows even turns on, before BitLocker is even a thought or a glimmer in the computer's eye, there is the UEFI screen, which typically is just wide open for anyone to set a password, configure a setting, boot to any type of USB stick. Well, there's a new sheriff in town, and it's called the Surface Enterprise Management Mode. And we're here to walk you through it with a couple of quick features of how can this further secure your devices.
Yeah, so whether it's for security or for convenience, there's a lot of really great features in Surface Enterprise Management Mode that you're allowed to disable through this tool.
Yes.
So these are normally features that we would love for you to have enabled, but we also understand that there are some situations where it makes sense to disable particular radios, drivers, and parts of the firmware at the UEFI level.
Effectively, this eliminates the need for you to have to go onto each individual device, set an administrator password, and then have to log in manually in that machine every time that you need to make a change. You can say, hey, at our company, we don't use the webcam. And if that is our policy, then you can go in here with Enterprise Management Mode before Windows even turns on and effectively cut power to that part, to that component. So there's nothing, no virus, no nothing through Windows that necessarily interacts here with this UEFI level. So it's extremely secure, but it's better than just one password because those can be forgotten. And if that happens, there's no changing it at that UEFI level. So this allows you as an organization to have a certificate to manage those settings. You create it, and of course, because it is before Windows, you must insert that USB stick. But that configuration package that you set has a good amount of configurable settings.
Yeah, absolutely. You can even set, like you said, a password to prevent tampering, so that way employees can't just change the settings back and get access to parts of the firmware that you need to shut down for security purposes. We have a lot of different features that, with very simple radio buttons that allow you to enable and disable different parts that you may need to. You can see here things like the cameras are a really popular one, especially in a particularly secure environment. That's a popular one to shut down. But also things like booting to USB. You may not want your users to be able to pop in, you know, a Linux distribution in there and be able to boot into that and run something malicious potentially.
Let's say your wired Ethernet network at your organization has a PXE boot as a part of that. This will prevent them from launching into PXE boot in order to re-image a machine. It will completely restrict the boot order, that further locking down the machine from tampering that is not IT approved.
And while you're creating your custom package for SEMM, we're going to ask you to just double check your certificate here. We want to ensure when you lock these things down that you absolutely, definitely want to lock them down. So make sure you write down that certificate number. So that way, if you do need to make changes back or just complete change of solution here, you can always have access to it.
It's a rather threatening window.
Yeah, it is.
It's probably one of the most threatening windows
I've
seen.
It does a good job of letting you know it's important.
This is irrevocable. It will be on that device until someone who's authorized removes it. But yes, once that is employed, you can enjoy this nice added security, and a place that was previously unmanaged can become managed and controlled by your organization.
To download Surface Enterprise Management Mode tool, just go to aka.ms/SEMM.